One of the most important parts of making the player move is the Animator Controller. We'll start off by creating a new Animator Controller and calling it Player Animator. Select the Animators folder in the project panel and click the Create button. Then choose Animator Controller. Name it Player Animator. This Animator Controller is going to be relatively simple. We'll start out with the parameters. If you don't have it open already, open up the Animator window. Go to Window, Animator. Create a float parameter called Speed. Click the plus button to the right of Parameters and choose Float. Name this Speed with a capital S. Now we'll need three booleans. First, one to say whether or not the player is sneaking, another to say whether or not he is dead, and finally, one for when the player is shouting. We'll call them sneaking, dead, and shouting, respectively. Now we are ready to start making the states. We'll start by dragging in an idle animation. This will be our default state. You'll find the FBX of this animation in the Animations folder, in the Humanoids subfolder. Open up Animations in the project panel and select Humanoid. You'll then find Humanoid underscore idle. Expand this FBX and drag and drop idle into the Animator window. Because this is our default state, it's highlighted in orange. And we want to see how this affects our character. So let's dock our animator below the scene view. Reselect our character, char underscore Ethan, in the hierarchy. In order to make this animation applied to our character, we need to drop the animator controller asset onto the controller property of the animator. Select the animators folder and drag and drop the animator that we just made. Now if we press play, we'll see that the idle clip is applied to our character. Press play once more and we'll continue. Reselect the animator window, and this time we want to add some motion. To get a smooth acceleration, we're going to use a blend tree. Create a new blend tree by right-clicking in empty space and choosing Create State from New Blend Tree. This is a new state based on a blend tree, and we need to name both the state and the blend tree. When we are in this view, we can see the state itself, and we'll name it Locomotion. Then double-click on this state to enter the blend tree. Now, rename the blend tree Locomotion also. We will add two motion fields to this blend tree by clicking the plus button and selecting Add Motion Field. Next, we'll add the two animations for the motion fields. First, add Walk and then Run. We'll do this by clicking the Circle Select button to the right of the motion fields, and then choosing the animation from the list. Search for Walk, and select it here. Then close the selection window. Then click the circle select button to the right of the second field, and search for Run, and select it. Finally, we can compute the thresholds. To do this, uncheck Automate Thresholds, and select Compute Thresholds, Speed. This will calculate appropriate values of the speed parameter for each animation based on their motion. Note the value of the threshold for Run. We'll be using an approximation of this later in our player movement script. Next, we can make the transitions to and from these states. Return to the base layer, and then right-click the idle state, and click Make Transition. This gives us a transition to drop onto another state. Simply click on the locomotion state to apply it. To edit the transition, select it. We then have properties for it in the inspector, and a condition for us to go from idle into locomotion. The conditions need to be set so that speed should be greater than 0.1. So from the drop-down, select Speed, leave the default of Greater, and say 0.1. We also need sneaking to be false, so click the plus button to add another condition, choose sneaking, and set it to false. Now we need a transition to go back to idle from locomotion. So right-click on locomotion, choose make transition, and click on idle. Select the transition back, and the condition that we need here is that speed is less than 0.1. The next state is sneak. The FBX of the animation is again in the humanoid folder under animations, and is called humanoid_sneak. Expand this, and then drag on the animation called sneak forward. We'll arrange these a bit more tidily. You can drag states around in the window in order to make them neater. Grab locomotion and move it out of the way, and then move sneak forward up to the left to form a triangle shape. You can hold down Alt at any time to drag around inside the animator window. For simplicity and consistency, let's also rename our state to simply sneak. Make sure it's selected in the animator and rename it at the top of the inspector to simply sneak. Let's deal with the transitions to and from locomotion first. In both cases, we need to make sure that speed is greater than 0.1. And if we're transitioning to sneak, then we need the sneaking parameter to be true. If we're transitioning away, we need it to be false. Select the locomotion state, right-click and make transition. Then select sneak. Select the transition to edit it in the inspector. And in the conditions table, make sure that speed is greater than 0.1, and then add a second condition, which says that sneaking should be true. Now we need the transition back. Right-click on sneak, and click on locomotion. Select the transition back, and in the conditions, ensure that speed is greater than 0.1, as it needs to be in order to walk or run, then add a second condition that says that sneaking must be false. Now we need the transitions to and from idle. To go to idle from sneak, we simply need speed to be less than 0.1. However, in order to go from idle into sneak, we need that speed is greater than 0.1 and that sneaking is true. Right-click on sneak and choose make transition. Then click on idle. Select the transition and set the condition for speed to be less than 0.1. Now right-click on idle and choose make transition. Then select sneak. Select the transition and under the conditions, ensure that speed is greater than 0.1. And then add a second condition that says that sneaking must be true. The final state that we're going to make on this layer is dying. We do so, as before, by dragging the animation into the animator window. The FBX is in the same folder as before, and is called humanoid_dying. Expand this FBX to reveal the dying animation. We need this state to be near the any state, as we're going to transition from this. Rearrange your states so that any state is over to the left of our existing states. Then drag and drop the dying animation into the animator window. The any state is there to allow us to transition into another state without being in any particular state to begin with. So, in order to die, we could be in any of the existing states. Rather than making transitions from all of them, we can use any state to jump out of our other states into another state. So, we can right-click on any state, choose make transition, and select dying. Select the transition, and in the condition, we need dead to be true. And there he is. Next, we're going to have an additional layer of animation so that the player can have a shouting animation whilst in any of the states in our base layer. Before we can do that though, we need to make an avatar mask so that only the parts of the player that need to move do so when shouting. You'll find the shouting animation in the same folder. It's called humanoid_shout. Beneath this, you should see the shout animation itself. Select the FBX, and you'll see that when playing it back, the character raises his arm to his mouth to shout. However, we don't want the rest of the motion from this to be affecting our character, so we will create the avatar mask. We'll save this into the animator folder as it's used directly with our animator. Select the animators folder and create an avatar mask. We'll call this player shouting mask. With this asset selected, we can edit it in the inspector. We only need to use the body mask, so expand this area now. Now deselect everything other than the left arm, hand, and head. Now we can make our additional layer of animation. Everything we've made so far has been on the base layer. We can add an additional layer of animation by clicking on the plus icon to the right of Layers in the top left of the animator window. We'll name this new layer Shouting. Next, click the circle select button next to Mask and choose a mask to apply. Choose Player Shouting Mask here. By adding this second layer of animation and masking it, we'll be able to call it via script during any other state of animation. Now we're going to add some states to this layer. The first thing we want to have is an empty state. Do this by right-clicking and choosing Create State, Empty. We need this empty state so that when this layer is not in the shout state, then nothing is being played back by this layer, and therefore nothing is overriding the animation on the base layer. Now we'll drag in the shout animation. Reselect the humanoid folder under Animations and expand Shout. Drag and drop it into the animator window. Finally, we need some transitions to and from these states. The condition for transitioning into the shout state is that the shouting boolean is true. So right-click on the empty new state and click Make Transition. Then click on Shout. Select the transition itself and under Conditions, choose Shouting. By default, it should be set to true. Then right-click on Shout, choose Make Transition, and select the orange empty state. Select the transition back, and you should see that it's set by default to exit time, which is the default that we need. This means that when the animation is finished playing, it will simply transition back into the empty state. That concludes our work on the player's animator controller. Save your scene, and save your project now.